Welcome back, everyone. I hope you're enjoying the videos and looking forward to see what comes next as much as I do. I'm the Laminal, and today I'm going to talk about the development of Star Citizen, specifically how far we've come and the dreaded feature creep. For those of you new to the channel, welcome to the journey. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And if you have any suggestions for me, put them in the comments below. One thing we all hear about Star Citizen is the amount of time it's taken to produce a playable game, but if we break it down to what we know, it's really not that bad. It just seems that way because, well, we're all part of the whole Alpha experience. CIG has studios in Los Angeles, Austin, Manchester, UK, Frankfurt, Germany, and contracts with Turbulent in Montreal, Canada. Each of these studios are dedicated to pieces of Star Citizen, and by having studios around the globe, production almost never stops. They work hard around the clock to bring us the latest and greatest tech, and not just Star Citizen, but the video game industry as a whole. When the Hangar module first released on August 29, 2013, this allowed us to finally see some of our ships in their full glorious detail. We could walk around, check them out, and dream of the day when we could finally fly them. I don't know about you, but when I first loaded it into the Hangar module, I had a blast messing around with the turret that allowed you to mount a ship weapon and fire it in your hangar. It was buggy as hell, but it was still fun to know the game was truly making progress. These are milestones. Fast forward to June 4th, 2014, when Arena Commander drops. Holy ship. The hype was real. We're flying all these ships that we've been looking at for hours in our hangar. Well, at least I was looking at the ships for hours. The weapons, the feeling of being free and experiencing the new environment that we constantly hit the simulation boundaries in. It was an experience for sure. You had to be there to know the feeling of first jumping into a Gladius or Super Hornet and just feeling like a god while you wrecked everything in sight. This was, until you hit a boundary wall or anything else that happened to be in your way. The map was small, but it was progress. December 11, 2015, CIG released Patch 2.0, lovingly referred to as the Mini Persistent Universe. The community affectionately dubbed this the Baby PU. This is Star Citizen. Every piece of technology gets crafted into the PU to make a bigger and better game with each and every patch. But more on this in a minute. So, where did we get a bit salty? If you remember back to those days, life was good. We were seeing progress. What happened? Enter Star Marine. After many delays and many missed deadlines, I won't say they made any promises, we finally see the FPS portion of Star Citizen December 23rd, 2016. This is where a huge portion of the criticism of Star Citizen really becomes evident. We'd been told many different dates and many different features, but as with the development of any major project, things change. So did Star Marine, namely, the studio producing it. Originally, Star Marine was subbed out to a third-party studio, but for reasons untold, or a contract not being renewed, Ilphonic was dropped, and the production of Star Marine was brought back in-house. Personally, I think this was a fantastic choice. I've never had an issue with the delays. Every time I heard something was being pushed back, I could envision a good reason. With the bugs we see already, I can see why they didn't want to release anything before it was ready. I understand we had release dates announced in the past, and they're far and gone. And that's where I personally leave them, far and gone. A memory in the past that doesn't matter because we've moved on to bigger and better things since those early days. Quality over quantity. Am I right? The great thing about this is we have the highest quality content available in a game that's in active development. Honestly, we get our cake and eat it too. Look at the quantity of ships and the quality of what's being released. We have reworks in progress as we speak on a number of different ships. The quality continues to improve each and every patch. This is about the point where we hear about the dreaded feature creep. An endless stream of new features added to the pipeline instead of just pushing forward in the development to progress to an end game. When you look at feature creep in that light, it sounds like a negative, but let's look at this in a whole new light. I see feature creep as the ideas of our community and the original vision of Chris Roberts. I believe he saw these features being lofty goals, but something he eventually wanted in the game and had to find the right group of extremely talented people to design and implement these features. It just so happens as the project developed, new employees came aboard, new technologies emerged, and he saw his opening to put the pieces of his dream, and honestly, ours as well, into the verse. This is not a bad thing, people. This means we'll have a fleshed out, more immersive game with each and every patch. Every quarter we're seeing the nuts and bolts being put in place, and every once in a while we see a piece of technology that no one saw coming. For instance, the procedural walking mechanic. It's a fantastic piece of work that has done nothing but improve the game. Just follow the roadmap. You can see how the technology comes together and progresses the game as a whole. Certain pieces of tech can't be implemented without a previous piece being fully implemented in tens of thousands of hours of gameplay testing the new feature. The beauty of Alpha is, we are the testers. We are the ones putting thousands of hours into finding out what works and what doesn't. You also have to consider when they develop the new technologies, they're brand new, never before seen features, and with that comes an insane amount of bugs. No new piece of tech comes without its initial hiccups. Bottom line, we're still seeing progress. We're still seeing an ever-evolving and ever-changing universe that does nothing but get better with every patch. You say feature creep? I say bring it on. Well, what about all the ships, Laminal? They keep pumping out new ships instead of new content. I say bullshit. Ships are features, and without a whole mess of ships, all with different roles, the game would feel empty and very vanilla. Imagine if Ford and Chevy were the only car manufacturers in the world, and they only produced a few different types of vehicles. That's so boring. Where's the imagination? Where's the realism? By having teams dedicated to nothing but ship development, we get more immersion, more realism. You have to remember, they don't take vehicle artists or vehicle programmers and designers and have them do other things in the studio. They have environmental artists, they have physics programmers, and the list goes on. They have people in specific departments continually working on pieces and parts of the game dedicated to their role. By creating more ships, it doesn't take away from the other aspects of the game. They have the people dedicated to those pieces of development. So give me feature creep, give me more ships, give me new features. And all the while, watch as the game progresses faster and faster. As the core tech comes together, more and more pieces of the puzzle fall into place. I don't know about you, but when I start a puzzle, I take the edges and frame it in first. Without the border, the inside is just a disorganized jumble of shit that frustrates you. Sure, you can finish it, but at what cost of time? CIJ is putting together the outside of the puzzle, and they're getting better and better at it every day. Let's put our efforts together to support and help the development of the game. We can continue to support and help by putting in the hours playing and testing the game. Nothing gets faster results than providing feedback to the team at CIG through my personal favorite tool, the Issue Council. Thank you for sticking with me through this video. I wanted to try and provide some perspective and offer a little peace of mind by pointing out we are progressing. We are seeing improvements, and the game gets a little bit better every single time CIG releases a new patch. Don't forget, we are testing this, and the feedback we provide really does matter. So get your video recording in the background, put the game through its paces, and when you find a bug, report it. Let's embrace feature creep, because the next feature could be the one that makes your jaw drop and tongue unroll. Until next time, I'm the Laminal, and I'll see you in the verse.